My name is Don Gorman. I'm the Director of Administration. In September of this year, I'll have been here for 10 years. The usual answer we get about our budget is the Sheriff's Office is not a revenue producing office like the County Clerk's Office, things like that. It costs money to run the Sheriff's Office. Of course, it comes out of tax dollars. We are a service producing agency. Our product is services provided. Our people are out 24/7 or in the jail 24/7, 365. The sheriff is given a budget. It's broken down into different areas: capital, payroll, operating, and they can't be mixed around. You can't mix them up. I can tell you this year, we had a $31 million budget, about another $1.5 million in capital. We're asking for an additional $4.5 million this coming year. Now this year we got $1.5 million. That's the most we've ever gotten since I've been here. Unfortunately, we don't always get 1.5. There's been years where we got 300,000, 400,000, and that's not even enough to replace the vehicles that we need to rotate out every year. We put 30 to 40,000 miles on our vehicles every year, and at the end of 5 years, they're worn out. They're absolutely worn out. We need to replace them, and if they only give us 300,000 or 400,000, that's not enough to replace them. Not 25 or 30 a year, which is what we need to trade. Financing, it's complex. I will say that. It's very complex. We've got a CPA that handles it here. We've got a couple other accountants that work for us, and then there's numerous accountants all the way up the line, including auditing and finance. It's as big as a hotbed as any place in the sheriff's office. It's always moving. It's a living thing. The budget is a living thing. The sheriff is briefed weekly at the staff meeting on what funds we have, what we're buying, what we're doing with the money. But he's also briefed on a daily basis if we're making a major purchase of some kind or we're expending money of some kind. We have people watching the money and people watching the people that are watching the money. So it's a checks and balances system. It works, it's workforce, but it is busy. About December, we start telling the division commanders to start getting their budget ready to submit to the sheriff. Everything they need, we ask them to submit it. Hold back on nothing. My division takes the budget request. We consolidate it into one. We roll up everything they've asked for, money-wise, personnel-wise, equipment-wise. We sit down with the sheriff, the chief, and all the other command staff. Normally, we'll go from this level down to this level before we submit it. It arrives at county finance. They usually have it for approximately a month and a half before they tell us what they've approved or disapproved. But before they do that, the sheriff, chief, and I usually go over and talk to them and make our case as to why we need certain items. About the middle of May, the county commission has a budget hearing, and the sheriff is given 10 minutes for his budget to make his case, which is not very long. 10 minutes isn't a whole lot for a $4.5 million increase. The county commission gets a copy of it, and they usually take a week or 10 days, and then they vote on the budget. They either approve it or disapprove it, or they could approve it with cuts or with certain amendments to the budget to make it more feasible. Usually that takes us right into June, and the new budget starts July 1st, so they've got to have it done by the end of June. I know I'm going to leave it better than it was when I got here, and that's all you can really hope for is to leave it better, but I would like to leave it at the top of the pyramid. You know, I want us to be the best, I want us to have the best, and I want us to do the best. When I got here, there was no laptop computers in the patrol cars, and now we have them in brand new ones, Dell computers in all 125 cars. We're working on getting arbitrators, which is an in-car video camera, in all the cars by the end of this fiscal year. So that's an accomplishment in itself. We've added probably 50 cameras in the jail to protect the inmates and to protect the workers over there. And we've added tons of printers, scanners, fax machines, copiers to the array of equipment that the sheriff's office has. As far as the command staff, I think we all complement each other very well. I think we get along real well. I think we've got a great command staff. I would put us up against any command staff around the state. And in fact, we get calls from a lot of the other sheriff's offices asking how we're doing things, how we're doing this. I can tell you, at the last sheriff's conference, the head of the Sheriff's Association looked down at us and he says, "Hamilton County, we're watching you. The whole state's watching you, so do right, do good, because we'll be following." And that's, you know, you can't get a higher compliment than that the rest of the other 94 sheriffs are watching your sheriff's office, you know?